There we go. Gonna be collecting the score for Joe taking his home map right now, though we're gonna be heading into home map for Pegasus. So what is going to be? With different gods. So you're gonna be looking forward to different matchup. You're gonna be expecting something a whole lot different right now. Medit? Hmm. Yeah, it's a nice idea, but you cannot play Zeus. Map allowed. I'm just kind of waiting if they're gonna be figuring out they cannot be play same, cannot be playing same gods in the match. This is gonna be having a bit of a fun here. Yeah, Joe is well aware, so he's gonna be right now telling to house to Pegasus. So Poseidon. Yeah, it kind of makes sense. Still quite a good god for this, so I don't think it's a problem. Yeah, I think it's not really that much different. Unless he's fast heroicin into Skillas. On Mediterranean, it's a really good strat. Hmm, Zeus from Joe, really? No, he can be kind of making fun. Maybe a Pegasus slightly taunting him with that. Kind of thinking Zeus with fast heroic against the Poseidon could work. Question is if maybe Joe doesn't want to be keeping Zeus for an uncomfortable matchup later. I think that's a thought that's probably going through his head at this point. And that's a very legitimate thought. But anyway, yeah, it's gonna be Zeus in the end. I think it's worth it. I think it's worth it right about now for him. So Poseidon vs Zeus on Mediterranean, the first home map for I am housed aka Pegasus. And therefore, let's have a look how the players are gonna be spawning. Pegasus also doesn't have any Vetos. Vetos are available only for Joe at this point, two of them. Still in this match, quite nicely. All the chickens are already gonna be running around randomly in there. That's one of the boat, or rather one of the boats. Boat making facilities, aka docks, gonna be coming all the way to the right into a bit of a dent, sorry. To the dent, so that's... He will have to be hoping he's having fishies there, otherwise he's not gonna be all that efficient spot. As on the left side, well, maybe into the middle would be slightly better, but who knows. Maybe he's gonna be getting a bit of an advantage out of it, because here in 1v1s, we are having smaller waters. So it doesn't have to be such a bad thing as in, for example, team games. It's a bit more trickier. You can see he's gonna be having threesome in a good position in the end. As all the way here, Joe is gonna be coming a bit more into the middle, probably preparing for a second dock bat here, a bit closer, so that he does have defense on the shoreline. Like good old Normandy in there. So all the way to the top, just going for the build order with the piggies, pretty much the same all the way to the bottom, as he's also gonna be luring the aurochs, and no, I kinda hope this is not this auroch from this duo. I was thinking it might be. If so, that's unlucky. But yeah, well, in the meantime, there's gonna be a relic on the left side for 250 village pierce damage. So that's exactly what it does, that relic, the one shot onto the villages. Killing animals in single shot because it increases the damage so hugely. It's not a thing different in that, just it really is going to be giving you such a huge amount of damage against animals. 250. Well, poor guys, they're gonna be pretty much exploding when you hit them with that kind of damage. But anyway, few piggies coming right about now for Joe. How many are there actually right now combined for the players? 6 for Haust, for Pegasus, not that many for Joe, but he's gonna be getting exactly right now the deliveries. It's gonna be 6, about like 8, 9 even. Not bad, not really bad at all. So all the way here, the TC apparently don't seem to be in water range. This one is, no, scratch that, this actually is in water range. Almost seemed like it wasn't, but it is. It definitely is in water range in here. That probably is gonna be meaning there's gonna be also a TC somewhere here for the blue player, and it's gonna be also in range. Yeah, well, gonna be seen a bit later. A bit later indeed, and let's kind of see what kind of build order they're coming for. So far, 5 on wood, 5 on wood here to the bottom, gonna be 8 on food and 8 on food. So they're going for pretty much the same build order, both of them. So far, nothing, anything different. Nothing different at all in there. That's to the top side. Interesting gold mine for right about now, Joe. And with the TC, the combination is definitely not bad yet again in water range, so it's gonna be exactly as we expected. But this is really nicely protected, even by the wood line. So Joe is gonna be having a really solid map. And it seems to me that house is not having that much different one, not a bad one. So if he's gonna be able to control this town center, or at least this part of the map, he's yet again going to be having this goal to himself. And of course, since both are having the front TC on the same side, it's gonna be leading naturally into a bit of a clash on the right. Okay, so anti-infantry damage, the Eye of Ornlu, the Wolf from Age of Empires 2. Fortunately, didn't survive until AOM, so his eye is gonna be in some kind of holy relic. This is gonna be a town switch into a bit of a gold. You can see Ares coming forward for house. And well, I'm just gonna exactly. That's exactly what I was also thinking about when I was talking about good choice with the Zeus Fasty Heroic for the matchup against Poseidon. Because the Poseidon could be going for the Pestilence, casting it soon into the Classical Age. And then if you go in for the Fast Heroic, then it's basically completely wasted. And considering that this matchup is not really played that often, and I'm thinking those two players exactly are not playing it all that often, then maybe something kind of like a bit of a deceit could be working rather well. But anyway, gonna be having to see a bit later. So far, 5 on gold. With hand ducks right about now for housed. Alright. 5 on gold. They're doing literally the same build order. There's probably gonna be some huge water battle on Classical Age. You can see second dog here. It's gonna be 3 dogs. It's advancing quite a bit later. If this is gonna be played well by house, he could be really putting his opponent into quite a bit of a problem. This is because this is obviously all pestilence. Maybe he's gonna be careful enough. He needs to be waiting about like 11 seconds after advance, because Triremes are taking like 13 seconds, 14. So you want to be having the pestilence right about when it's going to be popping out. I'm already messed up, or not yet. Pestilence, pestilence, pestilence. Missed it. Missed the window of opportunity. Right now I'm not entirely certain what he wants to be doing with it, because he's already going to be having a few boats against himself. Yeah, the most effective pestilence is before even the first are going to be out. Always repeat it, but players usually don't actually get it that way. They usually don't, even though the advantage is huge. 40 seconds without fishes, rather without boats whatsoever. So basically a minute after advance, you're gonna be completely useless. So right now there's the pestilence. And he's gonna be not having all that much of efficiency out of that anyway. It's gonna be resulting into ceasefire. Which is... no. I mean, like, ceasefire is not exactly... it's not exactly counter god power to pestilence, for the sole reason that you're gonna be just basically eating the pestilence, but it's not gonna be increasing... it's not gonna be increasing right about now your boats, whereas the opponent is still gonna be continuing with the boats. So it's gonna be, it really literally does nothing. It does nothing but give you a bit more economy on the water. If that is something that Joe wants, all right, that could be really good. But otherwise, really, it's not counter, ceasefire is not counter god power to pestilence. It really isn't. Okay, it's just some kind of like band-aid slightly. But anyway, there we go. It's gonna be pestilence gone. A few boats are gonna be coming forward. And of course, still scouting on the right side. Nothing much going on apparently in the bases. As far as I could be seen, just a bit of a protection of the gold, it seems to me. Right about now by red. And yeah, well, at least a few more boats are gonna be in for Joe. As he's of course producing from 3 docks. So that's a bit of an advantage for him. That's the reason why he's right now able to get at least a few more boats out. And kind of like making up for the numbers. As opposed to house, we're basically building only out of 2 docks at this point. So, yeah, well, that's exactly the difference here. And of course, with all the docks right about now, only 1 shooting. These 2 are not shooting right about now. This one potentially could have. They, well, he really didn't. He really didn't in there. And therefore, you're gonna be right now waiting how well are gonna be players coordinating their water powers. So far it seems to me that was a bit of a quite nice kiting. Can see Joe falling for it at least a bit. Pegasus is gonna be having a bit of an edge, but the numbers are definitely getting no even better, I'm thinking, for Joe. Yet again, right about now, Pegasus falling for the kiting. Gonna have seen him going way too far away. This dog should be shooting, I think. Might be in range of this one at least. Maybe Joe doesn't think so, maybe it isn't, who knows. But anyway, at least the 1 dog shooting is obviously right about now quite a huge advantage. And the 3rd dog is certainly... certainly right about now pulling Joe quite significantly, even with those, like, I don't know, 6 3RMs actually missing because of the pestilence in there. So very well done. He's having hand axe and pickaxe, and the opponent probably should be having the same, right? Only hand axe in the end. Not having pickaxe yet. But it's on the way. It's already on the way at this point. So this is looking like how? 16, 17. Right about now 21. Holy crap, that's a lot of bows. Right about now 4 red. So potentially doesn't have to be falling back all that much. And I'm kind of interested if maybe some of them is going to be coming for... or copper shield sometime soon, because it could be making quite a bit of difference, especially looking at the numbers. So I'm thinking one of them could be going for that, but in the meantime it's right about now going to be House trying to get a third or going, and really good defensive build up, and it's gonna be very hard for Joe to right now overcome. Really going to be quite hard. The economy though should be strong enough right about now for House to be continuing with all of it, so hopefully he's gonna be right now able to withstand the potential pressure from Joe. I'm kind of curious about the economies right now, because they should be fairly similar, maybe slightly better for Joe. 90 out of 95, 99 out of 115, so you can see the bows exactly as we have said, and notice before, it's slightly better for House, for Pegasus. So, how many are shooting? This one is shooting, this one isn't. This one definitely should be depositing already the fishing boats in there, yes. And he's paying attention, this one could be probably shooting as well. Thinking it should, or rather could. As in the meantime, he's gonna be right about now. Apparently, House getting a bit of an advantage finally in the fight. Seems like that he's gonna be maybe even winning. As already all the way on the other side of the map, Joe is kind of watching how his opponent is moving onto the secondary gold mine already. Away the Cyclops coming forward, so apparently gonna be having a bit of a flying day, this Kataskopos, with his horsey. Yep, catching him by the foot. And actually look at that, it's kind of funny, because there's absolutely no movement with Rider. He's just basically like a bit of a toy, and he's not moving anywhere, he's not falling off or anything like that, so he basically opted for that kind of animation, so it looks slightly funny, catching the horsey in there by the foot and hoof and whatever like that. But anyway, I'm gonna be coming back to the water battle, and right now the numbers seem to be slightly better maybe for Joe. 22, no, they're probably equal. It almost looked like at least Joe was able to catch up. Desperately and impatiently waiting for some more engagements into the upgrades in this game. Let's see. So far nothing being researched all that much as the battle is still going on. 360, 87 pop limit. 106 pop limit from House. Having quite nice gold in there. Could be probably going for the upgrade first, I'm thinking Pegasus at this point. I kind of like milling around here and there, Joe's boats. He's trying to probably kite on the right side, but on the left side, not entirely certain what they were trying to do. Which of course is costing you quite a bit of extra DPS. And that's of course missing in equal battles exactly as these. As right now, Pemera is going to be falling back at least ever so slightly. But he's already having a bit of an advantage. Because guarding on the left side on the gold. Already underway, as yeah, well, right now Blue is gonna be moving exactly into the secondary gold mine himself, and just gonna be checking around slightly what's exactly going on. So armory not. No armory there. Alright. Is he trying to steal this TC? Maybe some kind of thought like that. Doesn't seem all that impossible, but nobody's going for upgrades. But this is slightly interesting. I'm wondering if maybe he's gonna be wanting to drop a few towers in there. Like a bit of a tower rush. AOC inspired. Nothing being researched at all. Yeah, right about now, Pegasus is definitely getting an edge. And you can see he's leading by about 300 points. Actually, right about now, 400 points on the score. And he's certainly doing quite a nice job. He's of course not gonna be able to finish with the dogs all that easily. Because obviously, three shooting dogs, that's gonna be really hard for only arrow ships to deal with. And that will be costing plenty of resources to him altogether. So, the water seems to be won, but it doesn't have to be won altogether and completely. It really doesn't, because there's gonna be plenty of chance right about now from Blue to be coming forward, as he's gonna be right now getting the rock, or the TC in there, same as his opponent on the other side of the map, and those bridges right now need to be escaping, as the plan for potentially getting this are gonna be pretty much gone. So this is gonna be probably resulting into a few more fishing boats. You can see he's already switching from the military into exactly getting the economy going. 30 TC at the same time right about now for Joe. Let's see if there's gonna be same reaction from House, or if he's gonna be trying to get heroic. Kinda thinking he should be getting heroic. Since he's gonna be getting the water, therefore his advances should be a bit easier. Getting a bit easier in there, and therefore, yeah, I'm gonna be right now, of course, looking into what is this gonna be resulting into for Joe, because so far he kinda is well aware that potentially his opponent was having some kind of secondary ideas about this part of the map, so he should be probably establishing himself a bit more. As the Centaur is just scouting, should be probably trying to at least wall a bit, a few parts there, so that he knows when his opponent is gonna be coming for him, as one of the rocks is in the end already gone. So maybe, actually, the comeback into the water is gonna be a whole lot harder for Joe than it maybe seemed at first sight. But there it is, that's gonna be a 30C for him, doesn't want to be risky and that he's gonna be falling too much back into the economy. Even though, of course, with the water, he's not having all that much of a chance of that. So he would be quite fine going just 2DC into the Mythic, and he should be having maybe even better echo than his opponent in the meantime, as he's right now throwing away the Centaur. And he's gonna be taking, of course, a bit of time yet again before he's gonna be jumping into the next age. So maybe potentially given at least a bit of a chance to his opponent in there. So resources for Joe, that's not entirely too good, of course, on the foot. He's gonna be having the problem for that. As house is gonna be getting not only the 3 TCs, but also the heroic age in pretty good timing for obvious reasons. As Plow is coming for both at the same time, but it's gonna be definitely a bigger problem for Joe at this point. Doesn't want to be even switching apparently into the berries in there all that much. Maybe even to the deer could have been going all the way into the middle, with both heroes coming to the left side, and apparently Mr. Cyclops is gonna be meeting his match with Theseus as well. And it's gonna, of course, right about now resulting into a bit of a fight that should be, of course, heading for Joe because of the heroes and the one mythical unit in here. So that's not a good fight all that much for Pemera, but he's probably gonna be already jumping into Aphrodite. Quite obviously, so I'm kinda curious if maybe right about now there's still gonna be a play to be had a bit later in the game, as a few military units are already coming forward from Housed for Underworld Passage for Joe. Like Underworld Passage somewhere, I don't know, here maybe, into the back TC it usually goes. With Colossi in the Mythical Age, it's certainly an idea for him, but he's first needs to be getting there, and right about now, since he doesn't have access to the water at all, it's not gonna be getting all that easy. And there was a bit of an attempt of going back in there, and unfortunately, yeah, well, it was well scouted and guarded right about now by Housed, and he is not gonna be letting anything like that happen. Still gonna be having to scout also the top side, because I'm fairly certain Joe is gonna be continuing with some kind of attempts like that. As opposed to the last game on Anatolia, Joe is gonna be attempting to make it as hard as possible at this point. As well, he'll all the way here. He's gonna be right now Pemera, still pushing forward with Archer Range and Stable, and hoping that he can be really somehow maybe getting rid of this DC fairly quickly, which he definitely could, because he's gonna be, I'm thinking, advancing through Artemis. You can see he doesn't have gold yet. He needs to be getting a few more upgrades into it. Already in Shaftmine and Bowsaw though, as he's starting with the market and trying to wall this part of the map as well, with the relic for the Fetters of Fenrir. That's all the way to the top side. The enemy villages, they are having, of course, only the baseline. As he's right now gonna be struggling on the resources, and another fortress here. Not a bad idea. I'm just kind of thinking that Artemis with Earthquake is gonna be resolving this situation, and then he could be just straight going into the main TC and deal with that. Definitely quite a bit of an option for him. You can see already he's having irrigation. Saltam for as soon as possible, as on the left side he's just keeping a lot of boats all around. Should be kind of just spreading them. Doesn't need all that many at this point. Can be quite easily producing just a few siege boats and be done with it. As this TC is right about now in water range, and Pemera just needs to be realizing. He obviously doesn't even need the earthquake that I was talking about here. Just needs to be having a few siege boats and goodbye TC. So siege boats here, earthquake there. Really, the cards and everything is against Joe at this point, quite significantly, and it's gonna be really hard for him, I think, to be doing against anything against that. And curiously enough, Pemera wants to be going for a bit of a longer game, going for Hephaestus and not basically just ravage the opponent right there and completely destroy his psyche. Oh, the combination of a few things with medium upgrades coming forward for the military, and of course the upgrades for the armor are gonna be taking a bit longer because of waiting for the next age. Okay, it's gonna be quite a nice protection with the Petroboli, but right about now just cutting through here, so we can be potentially sending a few units forward. It'd be coming forward here quite easily. Okay, there it is. It's gonna be a few piggies, actually four piggies right now destroyed. And it's gonna be bolt onto, that was Hippolyta, I think that was Hippolyta actually. Not entirely certain why he was killing her, but he doesn't have any mythical units, but alright. That's kind of fine. Maybe he was actually trying to get into a mountain or like Nemean lion, who knows. But nonetheless, Hydebat now Hephaestus is already in. Joe is probably gonna be still a bit further away, even though he's advancing through Hera already. So it's not really all that bad. And the main TC is gonna be now 30% in, so still about a minute off. The TC is gonna be Hydebat now gone, doesn't apparently even need to be using any siege boots for that. And well, he probably doesn't have any kind of good god powers, so he doesn't. Ceasefire was already used before, he's gonna be now trying to get it. Unfortunately, not exactly towards his advantage. Right about now, the situation in here, as the villages from the red player will be attempting to use the same. He's having right now heavy hippicons with copper weapons already underway. Rather, underway, already researched rather. As on the left, there's a bit of a wall in already done. You can see even natural wall in here, it's coming all the way across the map. And we're gonna be kind of checking on villages with the economy. Carpenters, quarry, irrigation, just missing flood control in there. As for the opponent who is right now running out of gold, he's still gonna be having one. Carpenters and shaft mine in there and only plow. Still does have about like 5,500 gold for him. And yeah, well, it's gonna be getting increasingly difficult, especially since he's gonna be fighting against 40 Cs fairly quickly. So right about now, we're gonna be right now watching all the way to the top. That's gonna be resulting into Hera right now probably having a bit of a outing. We're trying to get rid of plenty of villages. This is actually gonna be quite a massacre. You can see how many villages actually died in this brave attempt. And probably even more of them. Is he gonna be dying as well? Ah, he survived it all. The only village that survived it all. Definitely has to be feeling lucky right about now. He has escaped the wrath of the goddess. Zeus's wife in there, but already champion Hippicons, and the upgrade is probably quite soon gonna be coming forward as well. Copper shields already, fortified TC, medium matches and quarry on the other side, and of course the Medusa, the counter to all of those colossi. That's certainly gonna be working rather well for him, if he can be keeping it that way. Question is if maybe even a house is gonna be interested in all that many colossi. Now the bit of a fighting is right now breaking out, and it's gonna be quite easy fight for the red horses in there. Now all the way to the bottom, he is getting a bit of favor, not much. So it about now is building second armory so that he can be producing the upgrades as soon as possible. And this is looking really quite tilted towards right now the red player, and it's gonna be interesting to see if maybe Joe is gonna be finding some way how to do the underworld passage on the other side. Is he already preparing for that or not? No, he's not even making all that many units here. Just basically gathering gold on the left. And hoping to survive with the archer ranges. And some kind of hoplites on top of that. With oxyjuggernauts already in. Preparing and to somehow guard this DC on the right flank. But it's gonna be already easily Pemeras, aka Pegasuses. Yes, in the middle. The archers are now having only medium. Bronze weapons, nice upgrade for them. Heavy infantry in there on the other side. But champion hippicons with all bronze, or rather all copper. Heavy archers on top of that with huge population limit advantage. And bronze, a whole array of bronze already on the way. With golden apples and masons. Yeah, well, kinda know where this is gonna be heading. We really do know, as the market is already not underway. Almost seemed like that this could be trade. But nope, those are only units. As on the left side, the gold is inevitably right now only gonna be at half. As this brave village is actually trying to cut through the walls. Somehow get into the enemy in there. Now the TC is already finished, so therefore even more units are gonna be coming forward. And of course right now Joe is just kinda maybe trying to tire. He's maybe just trying to tire Pegasus so that in the next games he's not gonna be all at 100%. As this game is pretty much going only one way at this point. And yeah, Joe is right now recognizing that, yep, not even the slightest chance is there right about now. And therefore, it's gonna be resulting into a GG. And we're gonna be tied and still at least two games in this best of five are gonna be following. So let's check into the post game that was competently played by Pegasus with the Poseidon in there. Yep. Exactly. Exactly as we said at the start, faster heroic would have been a really good idea. Surprise to Pegasus, it might have been quick win, who knows. But nonetheless, seems like Joe is realizing kind of similar idea, and maybe at least at the ceasefire he could have been trying to switch the strategy, because the fighting on the classic age in there wasn't a bad idea. But that pestilence apparently put a whole lot bigger dent into the plan than maybe even he thought. Yeah, well, different build order overall, but you can see of course the economy is gonna be better for him because of all the water, and therefore everything being so much easier for him. But in the end, the same military count, 132. That's curious. course, completely different stats because of the ups and whatnot. And the upgrades are really not that much different either. Yeah, the ceasefire just didn't do anything on the water in there against Pestilence. It just that is not a counter god power really. It's not gonna be helping you. It helps you keep the economy going. If you need the economy for some reason, for example, if you want to be getting the faster hero egg, then it has sense. Then I would agree that the extra minute on the water is really good. For the faster hero egg, it would be making sense, but continue with the classical age fight. No, he almost managed it anyway, Joe. He almost did. So, wasn't that far away. Yep, kinda good. Good mentions in there. Exactly what you're talking about. 61 Triremes in there for Joe, 64 for Pegasus. Yeah, civilian unit is pretty much the same up until here, when pretty much the water was decided and it was just slight jump for house, nothing much. But it was enough. And of course the military had a huge battle. And then just wasn't able to get up, but still quite a solid destruction because of the... You can see how powerful Lightning Storm is. How it can be destroying you. Even destroyed a bit of villages in there. But it's only one trick pony. And you cannot repeat that. So, GG.